A whole lot more. Let's go back to the SABC parliamentary studios now. Bulelani Philip is standing by with one of the members, I think, of the IFP, one of the leaders of the IFP. IFP Bulelani, good evening once again.
Well, good evening to you, Griselda. As we've said, I've got the spokesperson of the IFP, Mr. Mkhuleko Hlengwa, who's going to be giving us his party's reaction to the resignation of Musi Maimane as the DA leader, but of course he does remain as the DA's parliamentary leader. So Mr. Hlengwa, thank you for joining us. Your reactions to this news?
Well, at the outset we must indicate that this is purely DA politics playing itself out, which means we've got very little role or input to play in it. All we can do is note it and wish Mr. Maimane well in his future endeavours, wherever they may be. As you've already pointed out, of course, he'll be remaining in Parliament until the end of the year. But this does present now an issue for the IFP, which we must look at very closely, because we are in cooperation governments with the DA in Gauteng and in KwaZulu-Natal. And so we have to now interact, of course, with the new leadership insofar as how that will play itself out. We pay tribute to Mr. Maimane for his role in the course of the work that we have done, of course, in managing these cooperation governments. It has not been easy. It has not been without its challenges. But most often than not, which has been all the time, albeit the differences, we've been able to find each other for the greater good of the people that we serve in the various municipalities. And of course he has been a change maker within the DA. That of course is something which must be noted, and has been able to push back on the many frontiers of the stereotypes which have categorized and characterized the DA over the years. The circumstances of course which he now lives under is for history to tell and for DA politics to actually deal with and play out. I personally know Mr. Maimane to have been and continue to be a good person, a good friend and a good South African, and has been very approachable and has been easygoing, and I believe that is part of the reasons why he was able to make the significant strides that he made within the DA to probably and obviously rise to the highest office of leadership.
Talking about coalition politics as well as the partnerships that you've had in the opposition benches, the direction of the DA, does it appease the IFP?
Well, we're going to have to assess what the DA looks like moving forward. They have to go to a special Congress, I imagine, or an early Congress to elect a new leadership, and we'll assess the values which will come out and the resolutions which will come out, and of course the tone insofar as cooperation has been concerned. The fundamental issue, and I think the DA will need to take a serious moment of reflection insofar as this is concerned, is that cooperation does not mean that if you are the leading party then that you are the alpha and omega. They do need to adjust their tune. Secondly, the narrative of the DA insofar as small parties is concerned, quote unquote, leading up to the national and provincial elections in May was of serious concern to us, because it is the so-called small parties whom they have relied on to actually be in government in certain areas of this country. So the DA must obviously enter into a mode of reflection, but as I say, this is not an issue for the IFP to determine. What we will look at is what comes out of the new leadership of the DA, and then we'll make a decision on the basis of that. Moreover, of course, we had not entered into a coalition with Mr. Maimane, we had entered it with the DA, and so whatever the circumstances may be, we will need to benchmark them against the party and not the individual. Of course, it does have a factor to play, but at this point in time, the DA is probably still trying to figure things out, and so it would be unreasonable for us to burden them with now wanting to knock on their door to seek clarity. We'll give them the space and time, but of course the urgency is not foregone. We do need to actually deal with these matters speedily.
Lastly, before I let you go, his decision to resign from the party, do you see him becoming weakened within the caucus?
Well, of course, he does not now have the authority of being party leader, and so that on its own will present certain challenges for the caucus for the remaining 5-6 weeks, of course, of this parliamentary term. But you see, the issue is that Mr. Maimane's options are still open, because he has not said that he's resigning from the DA. So he may have a power play that he wants to play out. Who knows? He might as well contest the election at the Congress as well. So we don't know. We can't speculate. So whether that weakness is permanent or short-lived, history and time will tell. All we're expecting is that the values of cooperation and collaboration, which have characterized some of the work we have done here in Parliament, must continue for the greater good of the country. Out of all of this, our interaction has been underpinned and driven by that narrative, and that's what has driven the healthy working relationship we have had with Mr. Maimanian. So we're expecting that whoever comes in to be elected as the leader of the team must understand also that our support in any of the municipalities where we support them has got terms and conditions, and first and foremost those conditions are the constitution of this country and the values which underpin that constitution and the Bill of Rights, including but not limited to pushing back on the frontiers of racism.
Right, thank you so much, Mr. Mkhuleko Hlengwa. He is, of course, the spokesperson of the Inkatha Freedom Party. Well, of course, we've been trying to get comment from some of the opposition parties, namely the EFF. Dr. Mbuyiseni Ndlozi is saying outright that they are staying out of this one and will not be commenting. So on that note, we'll cross back to you guys in studio.